Good morning. Welcome to Calvary International Baptist Church. I am Pastor John, and this is Brian.
大家早，欢迎来到哥伦哈国际浸信会。这是加牧师，我是白人。
You know, we just had our first live prayer meeting combined with Zoom here at Calvary, and the Lord blessed it.
我们刚刚举行了实体的这个教会的祷告会，还有合并在线上一起来进行。感谢主的赐福。
Next Sunday we're going to have an online YouTube communion service, and we're going to just send out through YouTube also.
下礼拜天是教会的圣餐主日，然后我们会进行实体的圣餐的聚会，也会进行线上的圣餐的聚会，一起合并在一起。
And you know, we have been closed for almost 2.5 months now, but it's good to slowly transition back.
教会因为疫情的关系已经暂停了大概两个多月的这个实体的聚会，那我想说现在是慢慢恢复的一个好的一个时间点。
So let's just start with the prayer this morning.
我们一起来祷告。
Heavenly Father,
亲爱的天父，
we thank you for who you are.
我们为着你是那爱我们的神献上感谢。
We thank you that even though we're in this pandemic situation, that you are still in control.
主啊，虽然我们在疫情的期间，但是你仍然作为王掌权。
So Lord, will you be with us this morning?
求你今天早上与我们同在。
Will you be with the people who are affected by the COVID-19?
求主也与那些受到疫情影响的人们同在。
We pray for healing, we pray for comfort for each one.
求主的医治与安慰与每个人同在。
And we pray that you will be with us as we come and study and worship you.
主啊，当我们来到你的面前，研读你的话语，聆听你的声音的时候，求你也与我们同在。
We pray in the name of Jesus.
祷告奉主耶稣基督的圣名。
Amen. And now I would like to ask Susan to give this week's announcement.
我们邀请牧师娘来看这个礼拜周报的消息。
Good morning, church. Welcome to Calvary International Baptist. Again, my name is Susan.
欢迎弟兄姐妹来到哥伦哈国际浸信会，我是诗恩。
We have some special announcements this morning.
我们来看一些周报特别的消息。
This morning, we had Calvary's first ever combined live and Zoom prayer meeting, as Pastor John just mentioned. We just want to thank God for this.
为着教会有史以来第一次举行实体的以及线上的这个合并的祷告会，来线上感谢主的赐福。
Today at 2 o'clock, please join us for Bible study on Zoom, and Pastor John will be leading us through Romans chapter 12.
下午的两点钟，我们要来研读罗马书的第十二章，欢迎弟兄姐妹一起在线上来学习。
Today, the youth will be meeting at 1:30 by Google Meet.
青少年今天下午一点半会在 Google Meet 上面一起来进行线上的聚会。
Now please take a look at your screen for this week's Calvary schedule.
这礼拜教会的聚会的这各项讯息，请看PowerPoint 屏幕上面所显示的。
Please take note of this coming Wednesday. We are back in the sanctuary, yay! For Wednesday night Bible study, Pastor will continue through the study in 2 Samuel. Join us from 7 to 8 p.m.
这礼拜三教会的查经，礼拜三晚上的查经恢复实体的聚会，我们来看撒母耳记下，欢迎弟兄姐妹有空一起来参与。
The YouTube service for the Wednesday night Bible study will be sent out after the live Bible study.
礼拜三晚上的这个查经聚会的 YouTube 的影片，在结束之后会送到网络上面，大家可以来一起来参与。
Also take special note that Sunday's 9 o'clock prayer meeting will be meeting at Calvary, and it will also be on Zoom for those of you who cannot join us physically. Please pray about joining us at the church for prayer time.
教会的这个祷告会在礼拜天早上九点进行，我们将恢复实体的聚会进行，也请大家为着这个实体的祷告会来祷告。 然后也同时有我们会在祷告会也会在线上一起来进行。
The rest of the Calvary schedule remains the same. Calvary will continue to have online service and fellowship for the week of August 22nd. Please check the Calvary Facebook and John's Calvary Line for group for more information.
我们教会的这个线上的礼拜一直会进行到8月22号。那有关就是聚会的讯息，请看参加牧师的这些群组以及教会的这个官网。
For tithe and offering, please take a look at your screen.
有关各种十一奉献以及教会的奉献，请看荧幕上面所显示的这些银行账户的讯息。
And now let's pray for tithe and offering.
一起来做十一奉献的祷告。
Heavenly Father, thank you for this morning, Lord. Another beautiful Sunday that you've given us, Lord. We just want to thank you for all the abundant blessings that you give. And Lord, this morning, I want to thank you. We want to thank you for each and every person that you've put on their heart to give, Lord, to your church, Lord. And I pray that these tithes and offerings that are given, Lord, would be blessed by you, and Lord, that they would be used to further your kingdom, to bless the church, to bless the community in whatever way you see fit, God. Thank you so much, Father, for all the blessings. In Jesus' name, amen.
Thank you, Deacon Rue. That was beautiful. Now we're going to have scripture reading. I'm going to ask Susan to come and read the English, and Brian will read the Chinese.
Leviticus 19:9-10. When you reap the harvest of your land, you shall not wholly reap the corners of your field, nor shall you gather the gleanings of your harvest, and you shall not glean your vineyard, nor shall you gather every grape of your vineyard. You shall leave them for the poor and the stranger. I am the Lord your God. Leviticus 19:18. You shall not take vengeance, nor bear any grudge against the children of your people, but you shall love your neighbor as yourself. I am the Lord.
Romans 13:10.
Love does not harm to a neighbor. Therefore, love is the fulfillment of the law.
利未记19:9-10. 在你们的地收割庄稼，不可割尽田角，也不可拾取所遗落的。 不可栽进葡萄园的果子，也不可拾取葡萄园所掉的果子，要留给穷人和寄居的。我是耶和华你们的神。利未记19:18，不可报仇，不可埋怨你本国的子民，却要爱人如己。我是耶和华。罗马书13:10，爱是不加害于人的，所以爱就完全的律法。
All right, thank you for the scripture reading. And, you know, when I first started the series on Leviticus, you know, a lot of people were wondering, you know, what's in Leviticus? What's to learn there? It's just a bunch of laws, and it must be very boring.
当我刚开始跟大家分享利未记讯息的时候，有人会觉得说，利未记不过是一些有关律法的规定。 感觉内容很枯燥，那里面会有什么东西可以教导我们？
And a lot of people thought that, you know, that's the Old Testament, it shouldn't even apply to us today.
有些人也会觉得说，那是旧约的规定呢，跟我们今天可能没有任何的相关。
But now, after a few months, a lot of people came up to me and said, you know, Leviticus is okay, it's not so boring at all.
经过这几个礼拜的一些宣讲跟分享， 那有不少的人就说，哎，利未记还不错哦，啊，里面的记载也蛮有趣的。And
yes, it is the old covenant, and we are in the new covenant.
确实，利未记是有关旧约的这些教导，我们确实在新约的时代。But
Jesus said he came to fulfill the law, not to abolish the law.
但是耶稣说他来是为了成全律法，不是为了要废掉律法。You
know, the Old Testament points to the New Testament, and both the Old and the New, they meet at the cross of Jesus, the Messiah.
我们知道旧约就是指向新约，然后新旧约就是在十字架耶稣这位救主上面来交汇在一起，达到最高峰。So
let's begin with a prayer.
我们一起来祷告。
Heavenly Father,
亲爱的天父,
we again thank you for this opportunity to come to worship you.
然后为着我们有能够敬拜你的机会来献上感谢。
May you help us to rest our minds and our hearts as we are here to listen to your word.
主啊，当我们聆听你的话语的时候，帮助我们的心、我们的灵能够安静在你的脚边。
May you bless this time.
祝福这个时刻。
We pray in the name of Jesus.
祷告奉主耶稣基督的圣名。
Amen. You know, this morning we are in Leviticus 19.
今天我们来到利未记第十九章。This
chapter is actually a hidden treasure in the entire Bible.
利未记十九章其实是整本圣经里面一个隐藏的珍宝。It
talks about worshiping God, it has certain rules for life, and even talks about tattoos for the body during that time.
利未记十九章有教导有关上帝的律法，甚至我们生活当中所应该面临这些规矩，甚至呢连刺青的规定都有。So
most of the laws are for the Jews under the sacrificial system, so it's not binding under the new covenant.
这些旧约利未记的记载是针对这些犹太人有这献祭系统所定的规定，好像并不是针对我们目前在新约的状况的我们。But
there are rules that are still written in the New Testament. 但是这个旧约的律法在新约当中我们可以看得到。
So what are the applications for us today?
那这些旧约律法对我们今天来讲，我们怎么来运用呢？
So did you know that the most quoted verse for Jesus out of the Old Testament is in Leviticus chapter 19?
你知道吗？耶稣最常引用的这个旧约的经文，就是在利未记第十九章啊。
You shall love your neighbor as yourself.
你要爱邻舍如同自己。
This is here in Leviticus 19.
这就记载在利未记十九章里面。
You see, Leviticus is all about holiness, and this chapter will show that love is the main characteristic, the main distinguisher of holiness.
利未记的重点就是 讲到有关上帝的圣洁，然后这个圣洁如何实际来运用，在爱中来实践呢？就在利未记十九章。
You want to know what the whole Bible is all about with all these laws and these prophets?
你要知道这个旧约里面有关先知跟律法的总纲，它是什么吗？
Someone asked Jesus this in Matthew 22:37 through 40, and Jesus answered them, saying this. Jesus said to him.You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your mind. This is the first and great commandment. And the second is like it. You shall love your neighbor as yourself. On these two commandments hang all the law and the prophets.
有人拿这个问题来问耶稣说，诫命当中什么是最大呢？在马太福音22:37-40，耶稣对他说，你要尽心、尽性、尽意爱主你的神。这是诫命中的第一，也是最大的。其次也相仿，就是要爱人如己。这两条诫命是律法和先知一切道理的总纲。
So Jesus used the Old Testament to show us what's most important in life for every day: to love God, to love others.
所以耶稣引用旧约里面的这个经文的记载，告诉人们什么是。最重要的，在我们生活当中最重要的呢，就是要爱人，你是要爱神，以及爱人如己。
So I always say, love God first, and the next thing is to love others, and the most important others, if you are married, is your spouse.
我经常跟大家讲说，爱神是最重要的。如果你是已婚的话，那其次你的配偶就是你要爱的对象。
And you know.Why is that? Because the two shall become one flesh.
为什么呢？因为在神的这个旨意里面，两个人要合为一体。
So love God, love your wife or love your husband, and the question is, are we doing that today?
爱神以及要爱你的配偶，但是问题是我们今天有照这样的来做吗？
You see, this love that Jesus was talking about.Is totally different from this world's love.
你知道吗？耶稣所讲的这个爱，跟世人所讲的是完全不一样。
Paul wrote about this type of love, Romans 13:9-10. For the commandments, you shall not commit adultery, you shall not murder, you shall not steal, you shall not bear false witness, you shall not covet, and if there is any other commandment, are all summed up in this saying, namely.You shall love your neighbor as yourself. In verse 10, love does no harm to a neighbor. Therefore, love is the fulfillment of the law.
使徒保罗在罗马书13:9-10这样说：像那不可奸淫、不可杀人、不可偷盗、不可贪婪，或有别的诫命，都包在爱人如己这一句话之内了。爱是不加害于人的，所以爱就有完全的律法。
Love is what distinguishes us from the world.
爱是让我们跟世人有所分别。
The love we receive from God should naturally flow out from us to others is the sign of holiness.
你知道吗？从神，我们从神领受的爱，然后自然的流露出来，给予其他人，就是圣洁的一个最重要的表征。
So holiness.In the Levitical days, it's just how people are set apart from, by God, live in a way, live every day that is distinct from the rest of the world.
所以圣洁在利未记里面记载就是我们有了神的圣洁，然后我们跟周遭的这些一般的外人有所区别。
So for this section of the Bible, love in this chapter is another way of, for holiness
live in action, live every day for the good of other people.
所以在这一章里面，我们看到说爱，爱如何来表达呢？爱就是透过我们有圣洁的这样的一个生活行为，有圣洁的这样的一个作为，跟世人有所分别来展现出来。
God wants us to be holy.
神要我们成为圣洁。
Because God is holy and He dwells with His people who are also holy.
因为神他是圣洁的，他只住在圣洁的民当中。
So what does this look like?
这样是会怎么样来呈现呢？
I mean, how does one love one's neighbor?
一个人如何爱自己的邻舍呢？
I mean, how do we love others? How does this work in everyday life?
在我每天的日常生活当中，我们怎么样来爱邻舍呢？
You know, the Bible gives us practical ways, concrete things to do to show that we are doing what God says.
圣经教导我们非常具体可行的这个方式，让我们能够展现我们爱人如己的方式。
You know, love and holiness, they're not figurative, they're not imaginative. It's not what we think in our minds that we are holy, what we believe in our head that we are loving.
你知道吗？爱跟圣洁并不是抽象，并不是在我们的想象当中，它是非常非常的实际，可以运用在我们的日常生活当中里。
So loving others,in the Bible is real, it is concrete, it is tangible, and it comes with a cost.
所以圣经里的爱是非常具体的，是可以触摸的，可以实践的，而且呢，爱是带有代价的。
So what does it look like from God's point of view?
所以从神的观点来看，爱到底是什么呢？
Leviticus 19:9-10. When you reap the harvest of your land,You shall not wholly reap the corners of your field, nor shall you gather the gleanings of your harvest. Verse 10, and you shall not glean your vineyard, nor shall you gather every grape of your vineyard. You shall leave them for the poor and the stranger. I am the Lord your God.
利未记十九章九到十节，在你们的地收割庄稼，不可割弃田角，也不可拾取所遗落的。不可摘尽葡萄园的果子，也不可拾取葡萄园所掉的果子，要留给穷人和寄居的。我是耶和华你们的神。
The gleaning here is talking about generosity to others.
这里的拾穗就是我们对他人要有慷慨的心。
If you love your neighbors, you will love with your possessions, with your money.
如果你爱你的邻舍的话，你会。用你的自己的所有的以及你的钱来爱他们。
You know, you leave some of what is yours to others who do not have enough to survive.
你把你自己所有的，然后留一些部分给其他的人，这是一个爱的展现。
Don't take everything in the field, but leave some for the poor, for the sojourners just passing through.
在你的田地里面，我们不要把所有的东西都收取了。留一些给那些穷人，给那些寄居的，甚至从旁边经过的人。
You know, Boaz in the Old Testament did that for Ruth, who was a stranger from a foreign land who had nothing.
在路德记里，我们看到波阿斯他就留一些这个田地里面的产物给这个路德，因为路德他是从外地来的，是外国的，他身无分文的。
So Boaz.Showed extraordinary kindness to Ruth by telling his men in Ruth 2:15-16, and when she rose up to glean, Boaz commanded his young men, saying, Let her glean even among the sheaves, and do not reproach her. Also, let grain from the bundles fall purposely for her, leave it that she may glean, and do not rebuke her.
哇斯对路德有特别特别的宽待，在路德记二章十五到十六节，他起来又拾取麦穗，给波阿斯的吩咐仆人说，他就是要捆中收持麦穗，也可以容他，不可羞辱他，并要从捆里抽出些来，留在地上任他拾取，不可斥喝他。
Let's be generous. She is a widow taking care of her mother-in-law.
波阿斯说，让我们慷慨一点吧。她是外邦的女子，然后照顾她的婆婆。
I know all this stuff is mine. I know we could sell this and make money, but let's give her some for her family.
波阿斯说，这所有的收成都是我的，我知道。但是让我们留一些东西，让她也可以来享用。
Let's be generous to the poor.
让对穷人要有慷慨之心。
You know what Boaz did was on top of the tithe.
你知道波阿斯所做的是在十一奉献以外更多的。
You know the tithe back then, if you take it all the tithes to the priest, all the tithes for the harvest, for the animals, and add them all up, it's more than 20%, not this 10% stuff.
你知道吗？当时的这些所谓的十一的奉献，如果你把给祭司的、把这些献祭的这些牲畜、这些收成都加起来了，是超过百分之，甚至是20%的。
All the people back then, they have an understanding that God gave them everything. Everything belongs to God, and they want to give some back to God.
当时的以色列人，他们非常清楚，他们所有的一切都是神所赏赐的，所以他们乐意奉献给神。
But this generosity was on top of the tithe.
但是这样的一个慷慨是在十一奉献之外又更多的。
This was not for the priest, not for the temple, but specifically for the poor.
这不是给祭司，也不是给献圣殿献祭所用的，而是特别留给穷人的。
Again, the people in this period of time, they understood this section of the law.
当时的人们对利未记这样的这样经文的记载是非常清楚的。
Gleaning was a choice, a decision made by one's own choice by not holding on to everything that belonged to you.
你知道吗？让人十岁是自己内心所做的决定，说这我不要收取这所有的一切，我要留一些给穷人，是他自己乐意的决定。
It allows the poor to benefit from people who made the choice.Not to maximize their return on investment and chose not to gather with the attitude that, hey, this is mine. It's all my grain, it's all my grapes.
这十岁的概念就是这些拥有者，他说我不要把我所有的投资的收取全部都归于我自己，这些都是我的，不，他们不这么想，他们说我要留一部分，特意留一部分给这些穷人来享用。
It's not trying to grab every single penny and it's all mine.
不是说抓取每一分钱说这些都是我的，不是的。
No, that's not God's way.
这不是神他的心意啊。
Gleaning means to purposely leave some behind for others from the very beginning.
从一开始十岁这个观念就是我特意留下一些给别人，让他们来用。
It was God's plan for us to help others in need.
你知道吗？对那些有需要的人，上帝要我们去来帮助他。
So what does it mean for us today?
那这个对我们今天来讲，它的教训又是什么呢？
It means we should have a regular routine for giving.
知道吗？我们应该要经常性的、规律性的留一些来给别人。
It could be for your church to charitable organizations or to people in need.
或许是给你的教会，或是一些慈善组织，或者是那些有需要的人。
But don't do it if your heart is not in it.
如果你的心还是有犹豫不定的话，不要这么做。
Don't pretend because God sees the heart.
你知道吗？我们不要假装我们乐意慷慨，因为神看我们的心。
God loves a cheerful giver, and if you feel like you're forced to or pressured to give, please.Don't do it.
神要的是甘心乐意奉献的心。如果你觉得心里有勉强或者一些不甘愿的话，千万不要这样做。
God does not need your money.
神他不需要你的钱。
He owns everything already.
神他创造万有，万有都属他。
And don't ask people for a business plan or a resume or a presentation.On why they are poor and what they're going to do with their money, with the money.
你不要因为这些人穷就要他们写一份报告，写一份这些他们所收的钱要怎么运用的这些计划，千万不要这么做。
I mean, are there bad people out there who try to con people with impure motives? Of course.
你知道外面是不是有人刻意要骗我们的钱？当然有。
God gave us a brain and we should not be careless.
你知道吗？神让我们脑袋可以思考，可以有智慧，我们要小心。
If we know that they are lying, we don't give anything to them. God will deal with them in His timing.
这些要来企图骗我们的，我们不要被他骗了，因为神会在他们身上施行神所要的审判。
There will be natural consequences to sin.
罪恶会带来自然而然会带来。罪的后果。
And even if we're tricked, God sees the whole thing and he'll deal with them in his timing.
即使我们被骗也有什么关系呢? 神他掌管一切,看顾一切,神会在他的时间里面来做定夺。
But the reality is that there are many people in need who are poor that do not want to come in front of a committee or to a person to give a presentation of why they are poor or what they're going to do with the resources.
但事实上确实有些贫穷的人,他们误以为计, 他们也不愿意说我要带来委员会来做一些我这个金钱使用的报告或怎样的一个计划，他们也不想来这么做。
They just want to survive.
他们只想要生存而已。They
just want to feed their family to pay their rent.
他们只想喂养他的家人，能够付这些租金。They're
like they're just like people, just like Ruth in the Bible.
他们就像路德记里面这个路德这位外邦的女子啊。
Boaz saw a need, and he knew that Ruth had a good reputation, so he helped her without asking her to jump through any hurdles.
你知道吗？波阿斯看见路德他的需要，他知道他有一个照顾婆婆的好名声，所以波阿斯没有设下任何的障碍，让路德觉得难以通过。Boaz
followed God's plan, and he was extraordinarily generous.
然后波阿斯遵照神的律法，然后在路德这件事上，他对他特别的宽容宽待。Let's
be generous with a cheerful heart.
让我们以一个甘心乐意的心来做奉献。The
church you go to usually will have a fund to help people in the church with physical needs and to assist different organizations that need help.
我们来到了教会，他们通常都有设立一个基金，针对校外会有的需要，或是外面一些特别的需要，会把这些基金奉献出去。I
have asked Elder Henry to work with the Calvary Finance Committee to come up with a plan where this church, Calvary, can concretely help in this area, locally, domestically, and also international.
我邀请长老 瑞汉兄一起来跟教会的这个财务委员会，我们教会呢要很具体的针对这个社区以及外面可能其他世界各个地方有需要的，我们来做奉献。You
know, Calvary has been helping out the House of Grace in the Philippines, and yesterday they received the two big boxes that we sent to them, and they were so grateful.
我们知道教会跟菲律宾的慈善之家孤儿院一直都有这些联络，那 我们昨天才送了两大箱的这个礼物给他们，他们收到的时候非常非常高兴。
In the next few weeks, we hope to have some pictures that they'll send to us and we can show everybody.
几周后，或许他们会把一些照片拍来给我们，再跟大家分享。
So for you personally, what do you do when you get extra income?
但是我们个人呢，如果没有额外的收入的时候，我们怎么样来运用呢？
Buy stuff that you don't need?
买一些我们不需要的东西吗?
What about blessing others with the extra?
把这个多额外的收入我们拿来祝福别人如何?
You know, try it with a willing heart, be generous, and see what God does, and I believe you will be blessed.
让我们用一个甘心乐意的心来试试看，你知道你这样做的时候，神会祝福的。
Give it to someone you know who's in need.
让我们把这些多余的给那些有需要的人。Give
it to a charity that you know that's doing good in serving others.
让我们奉献给这个慈善组织，我们知道这个慈善组织确实具体的做一些好的事情。You
see these margins at the edge of the field? They were not gleaned, not harvested from the beginning by choice.
你知道吗？这是田的这个四角。 一刚开始，他就是不是要把它收拾，把它割取来收获的。一刚开始的设计就不是这样的。They
were following God's rule.
这些田角不收取，是在遵照上帝的这个诫命。It's
not the leftovers that were given to the poor, not the bad grains, not the bad grapes. You know, they gave the good fruit, not lean, not harvested fruit.
你知道吗？田地里面出产这个。 四维的这个狡辩，并不是剩下这个不好的谷物，不是那些烂掉的葡萄，乃是跟这个田地一样，是一样，都是好的东西，刻意留下来的。It's
not the attitude of, oh, I can't use this anymore. It's about to expire. So let's give it to the poor. Hey, maybe the pastor could use it.
你知道吗，并不是说，哎，这个东西快过期了，还可以享用，我把这个东西奉献给牧师，不是这样的态度。
Oh, We just had a great big harvest. We made a lot of money. Let's have a party. But we have a lot of leftovers. Let's give it to the poor so we'll feel better.
你知道吗？我们有个好的一个丰收，我们举办一个圣诞的宴会，宴会上面剩下的这个食物，有点很可惜，让我们拿给别人。不是这样子的。
It's not that the people at that time from the beginning planned not to harvest the margins of the field up front and they want to give to the poor generously with the good stuff.
因为记所记载，那个时代的以色列，他们一刚开始就刻意把这些边边角角的东西留下来，然后呢，要把这些遵照上帝的律法奉献给穷人的，让穷人来拾取的。It's
part of their financial plan set up by God from the very beginning, and they all knew that God has the best plan for life.
你知道吗？他们的财务计划就是遵照上帝的规定来设定的。他们知道上帝在这个上面有他美好的计划来实现，他们就照着去做。So
one way, what we can do is to set aside something that God puts in your heart monthly to give to people in need.
你知道，如果上帝感动你的心，或许我每个月就省下来这些钱，然后呢，把它累积起来，来作为慈善捐助之用。It
could be 100 NT. 500 NT, 1,000 NT, or if you make a lot more, 50,000 NT, 100,000 NT, just surprise people with it. It'll be a blessing to them.
可能是100块, 500块, 1,000块台币，或者是上帝祝福你，可能是5万块, 10万块，让我们把这些累积下来钱奉献出去的时候，让收到的人让他得到惊喜。
You have a blast. You have a lot of fun looking for ways to bless people.
其实我们有很多很多可以让人家感受到惊讶，感受到祝福的这些奉献的方式来进行。You
can take them to have a wonderful lunch, a wonderful dinner.
你可以带他们去吃一顿午餐晚餐也可以。Have
your eyes open to the needs that's around you.
让我们睁开眼睛看看四周的需要吧。So
if this month God did not bring anyone to you, save it for the next month and keep adding to it.
如果这个月上帝没有把这些需要人带到你面前，或许我们就留下下个月一起再来分享出去。It's
actually your gleaning fund to bless people with.
这是你的十岁的基金，用来祝福他人。You
know, we say to the Lord, Lord, this fund is on top of the tithe and offering, and is to bless the people you bring to my life so they can be blessed.
你可以向神说，神啊，我要需要准备一个十岁的基金，这是在十一奉献之外的，让我把用这个十岁的基金来祝福他人，遵照你的命令。The
people that's in need that you bring to my life, this is for them.
主啊，求你把那些有需要的人带到我的面前，让我把这个十岁基金奉献给他们。And
you ask the Lord, will you lead them to me or lead me to them?
主啊，你可以这样祷告，求你把这些人带到我面前，或者把我带到他们的面前。Don't
be stingy with your money.
让我们不要对我上帝所赐福给我们金钱吝啬。Treat
your money like the Israelites were supposed to treat their vineyards.
让我们遵照这些以色列他们把这些十岁的这样落实在他们生活当中，让我们也照着去做。We
should set aside something, and when you see the poor coming to your field, you'll have something on the margins for them to be blessed with, for them to enjoy.
让我们建立我们自己的十岁的这样的一个概念跟基金，当有穷人来到我们的田边的时候，让他们可以收取这个田边四角的这些收获。This
is what love with your possessions look like.
这就是用财物来爱他人具体的实现。You
should love your neighbors as yourself.
你要爱邻舍如同你自己。
To love our neighbors, to love others, we also need to love with our words.
你知道吗？爱邻舍跟爱他人，我们要用我的言语来爱他们。
To love is to tell the truth.
爱人就是告诉真实，就是用真理来做。
As I said, the most important others in one's life, God first, and then others, the most important others is your spouse.
你知道吗？爱 爱这个爱神是第一最重要，然后爱你的配偶也是。
Are you truthful with your spouse?
你对你的配偶有真实完全坦诚吗？
Is there anything that is in your heart that you're harboring against your husband or your wife?
在你的心中有对你的配偶有所隐瞒吗？
We need to be honest even if it hurts.
即使是很痛苦的事情，但是我们要对我们的配偶诚实。
Honesty is also important both in the courts and in business.
你知道吗？在诚实这个在法庭跟在企业里面也是非常非常重要。
Leviticus 19:11, you shall not steal, nor deal falsely, nor lie to one another.
利未记十九章十一节，你不可偷盗，不可欺骗，也不可彼此说谎。
Stealing is taking place when one's lying to people.Dealing falsely with another person.
当你对别人说谎的时候，当你对别人错误待他们的时候，其实就是一种偷盗。
God says, when you love, you tell the truth in all your business transactions. You advertise in truth.
神说你要真诚实的话，就是在你所有的交易，你是在你的所有的这些甚至生意的广告上面，都要必须是真实的。
Don't promise any more than you can deliver.
我们绝对不要食言而肥。当我们承诺的时候，不要超出我们所的能力范围来说承诺。
God's principle is people first, then give the best product next, and then profit.
神的这些。规矩就是以人为最优先，然后你的所产出的这些产品，然后再来就是你的利润。
But that's not the way of the world. That's not what I learned in my MBA school 30 years ago.
但是这不是这个三 P 的原则，并不是这个世界的法律的规定。在我30年前念 MBA 的时候，也不是这样教的。
We also need to tell the truth in a courtroom. Leviticus 19:12, and you shall not swear by my name falsely.Nor shall you profane the name of your God. I am the Lord.
在利未记十九章十二节，不可指着我的名起假誓，亵渎你神的名。我是耶和华。
Love demands that we are very careful with our words.
爱就是让我们说话的时候要非常非常的小心。
Love your neighbor means to be truthful to them.
爱我们的邻舍就是要对他们坦诚相待。
Are you or am I?Doing that daily.
我们有每天这样子对人诚实吗？
So we love with our possessions, we love in truthfulness, and now we love in our actions.
你知道吗？我们用我们的这个财务来爱邻舍，然后用我们的诚实来爱邻舍，然后现在用我们的行动来爱他们。
Leviticus 19:13-14. You shall not cheat your neighbor nor rob him.The wages of him who is hired shall not remain with you all night until morning. You shall not curse the deaf, nor put a stumbling block before the blind, but shall fear your God. I am the Lord.
利未记十九章十三到十四节，不可欺压你的邻舍，不可抢夺他们的物，雇工人的工价，不可在你那里过夜留到早晨，不可咒骂。聋子不可将绊脚石放在瞎子面前，只要敬畏你的神，我是耶和华。
In those days, they had employers who oppressed workers.
你知道吗？当时有这些这每日领日薪的工人，他们是受压迫人群。
And even today, you hear about sweatshops all over the world.
在今天，我们甚至到全球各地都有那所谓的血汗工厂。
During Jesus' day, there were day laborers.That work for the whole day to get one day's wages, which is one denarius.
你知道当时耶稣的时代有那些所谓领日薪的这些工人，他们一天工作下领一银钱。
And some bosses would say, "Hey, you know, I didn't bring any money with me. You come back tomorrow."
有些工头就说，我今天没有带钱，你明天再来领。
But the day laborer needs that one denarius to buy food for their family, for the kids to eat that night.
但是个领日薪的领这个一银钱的工人，他们需要这个钱来买他们食物，恭喜他们的家人。
So some bosses would say, "Oh, you didn't do a good job today, so I'm not going to pay you."
有些老板说，你今天工作的效果不好，我今天不付钱给你。
Since the workers were poor, they couldn't hire any lawyers to defend them.
你知道这些工人他们很穷，根本没有办法有钱来雇请律师为他们辩护。
They need food for that day.
他们需要当那个钱来买当天的食物啊。
So there were no recourses for the poor when they deal with bad bosses.
当工人遇到这个不好的老板的时候，他们也没办法寻求补偿。
You know, I'm not talking about these employees who lie, cheat, and steal from employers.
我并不是说这些这些雇工他如果对老板有说谎的或是在偷窃的，我并不是在想这样。
Because God will deal with them, and there are natural consequences to sin.
因为神自然会审判他们。如果犯罪的话，自然会随之而来有不好的后果。
But this rule was here 3,400 years ago, where employers were already oppressing the workers.
你知道吗？这个规定3,400年前定下，当时就有这些工头、这些老板来恶待这些工人。
Oppression is not honoring your word.
你知道吗？如果你这样的压迫别人、欺压别人的话，并不是让你的行为是得到赞许。
This is not about the employer making money or making a profit. That's not oppression.
你知道吗？这并不是说这些工人他赚了很多很多的钱，不是如何。
It's not honoring what you said you would do. That's oppression.
你知道吗？压迫是什么？是你没有照着你的话来做的话，食言而肥，这就是没有得到这个尊荣。
And the rule said, do not curse the deaf.Do not put stumbling block before the blind.
神还说你不可诅咒，不可咒骂聋子，也不可将绊脚石放在瞎子面前。
We should not pick on people who cannot retaliate.
如果那些没有办法来报复我们的，让我们不要来压迫他们。
So we do not put hurdles or stumbling blocks before the blind. When we know that they cannot get over it.And they cannot physically do it, we should not put hurdles in front of them.
你知道吗？不应该把这些障碍物放在瞎子的面前。如果有人他实体上面、具体上面根本没办法办到的话，那我们不要设障碍在他面前。
If you don't want to be generous, then don't do it.
如果你不想慷慨的话，你就不要做。
But don't put hurdles up so high that you already knew that, oh, they can't pay it, they can't do that part.So I'm not going to pay them because I know already that they can fulfill this requirement.
你明明知道这些人根本办不到，你就不要设下那个根本没有办法越过的障碍，让这些人，因为你知道他们明明办不到，但是千万不要这么做。
The Lord sees everything, He hears everything, He sees our hearts.
神他是观照一切的，他知道我们内心所想，他知道我们内心所要做的。
And making fun of people.Is not love.
你知道吗？取笑别人那也不是爱。
So putting up hurdles in the name of protecting your assets is not love.
为了你自己的利益，然后设下这些障碍，让人家无法越过，这也不是爱啊。
To love our neighbors, we need to love them with our actions.
你知道吗？爱邻舍就要用我们实际的行动来展现。
We also love with our judgments.
我们也是用从审判单。审判当中来看爱
The setting here is in a court.
这个场景是在法院里面。
Leviticus 19:15-16, you shall do no injustice in judgment. You shall not be partial to the poor, not honor the person of the mighty. In righteousness, you shall judge your neighbor. You shall not go about as a talebearer among your people, nor shall you take a stand against the life of your neighbor.I am the Lord.
利未记十九章十五到十六节，你们施行审判，不可行不义，不可偏护穷人，也不可重看有势力的人。只要按着公义审判你的邻舍，不可在邻中往来搬弄是非，也不可与邻舍为敌，置之以死。我是耶和华。
Do not treat people differently because of the size of their bank account or their investment portfolio.
不要因为他很有钱，他的投资很广泛，你就有所偏私。
God is telling you and me, telling us to be impartial in our judgment, regardless of who they are.
神告诉我们，在我们的审判当中，我们要公正无私，不是看这个人的背景如何。
How do we do justice, and how can we be impartial?
我们如何来公正的施行审判，不偏私呢
？Is rendering the just verdict.Knowing that God sees everything.
你知道吗？就是神他观照一切，神知道一切，所以我们要照着他的话来做。
Justice is doing what is right according to the law, God's law.
你知道吗？公正的审判就是遵照这个律法，就是照着神的律法而行。
Justice is supposed to be blind.
你知道吗？公平是应该是眼睛看不见。
We should just do what is right.
我们要照着什么是对的来做。
We do what God says.
我们照着神所命令的来做。
Honesty and rule of law can help the poor.
诚实以及照着法律而行能够帮助穷人。
So we should judge fairly and we should speak honestly.
所以我们应该公正的审判，然后所说的话也要诚实。
This is how we love our neighbors, how we love others.
这就是我们如何来爱邻舍，如何来爱他人的具体展现。
So we should also love with our attitudes.
我们要在态度上面来爱他人。
So how does that work?
怎么样来实行？
Leviticus 19:17-18, you shall not hate your brothers in your heart. You shall surely rebuke your neighbor and not bear sin because of him. Verse 18, you shall not take vengeance nor bear any grudge against the children of your people, but you shall love your neighbor as yourself. I am the Lord.
利未记十九章十七到十八节，不可心里恨你的弟兄，总要指摘你的邻舍，也能因他担罪，不可报仇，不可埋怨你本国的子民，却要爱人如己。我是耶和华。
So here is a verse that Jesus quoted the most.
这一段的经文就是耶稣引用旧约里面最多次的。
We need to talk it out, work it out with people that we're having problems with, to be open about what you're thinking, so you don't sin, so you don't hate.
当我们与别人有芥蒂、有嫌隙的时候，让我们诚实、坦诚地说出来。然后呢，一个这样子坦诚公开，然后彼此之间不再有任何的记仇。
Don't just bury it deep into your heart.
不要把这些恨意、这些仇恨越埋越深。
You know, think about this. What if it's you who hurt someone?
如果是你，我们想想看，如果是你伤害别人呢
？So do you want that person to just run away, get mad at you, hate you? Would you want that friend to come openly and talk to you and resolve the problem?
你要这些受你伤害的人，他远远避开你，然后呢，心里怀恨，然后不跟你讲话，还是说你希望他，我们两个人能够好好的坐下，把这件事情好好的谈开呢
？You know, most of us we like to protect ourselves and not expose our true feelings. We like to run away and just don't want to deal with it.
你知道，大多数的人他不想要坦诚面对，只想远远的躲开，不想真实的来面对这样的状况。
But God says no, don't do that.
但是神说不，不要这么做，让我们坦诚而行。
We are to treat each other rightly with our actions, but we, you know, sometimes we just treat each other rightly just to look good from the outside.
你知道，有时候我们想说，我们应该 要好好的来对待他人，但是我们心里所以想说，我只是想啊外表上面，但是我内心并不想这么做。
But we also need to have the right attitude, the right heart, because God sees the heart.
当我们要公开来谈这样的事情的时候，让我们有一个正确的态度，因为神是看我们的内心。
Do your actions and is what's in your heart, do they match?
当我们的行动以及我们内心真正的动机，他们是相契合的吗
？If you want to love God, if you want to love others, you need to get to know God's laws and God's commandments.
如果你要爱神以及真的要爱人如己的话，你要真正明白神的诫命以及神的律法的真意所在。
This is what Jesus said in John 14:15. If you love me, keep.My commandments.
这是耶稣所说的，在约翰福音十四章十五节，你们若爱我，就必遵守我的命令。
We love by sharing.
你知道，我们透过爱来分享。
We love by telling the truth.
我们透过讲诚实话来彼此相爱。
We love by helping the weak.
当我们帮助一些弱者的时候，我们展现我们的爱。
We love by being fair.
我们透过公正来爱。
We love by talking it out and not burying it inside.
我们透过坦诚相告，而不是深藏在内心里面来爱。
If you want to know love, and if you want to love, you get to know the one who kept all the laws, and that's Jesus.
如果你想明白爱，以及想到知道如何去爱的话，让我们来到这位神耶稣的面前，因为他是那爱的源头。
Our Jesus can help you and me love our spouse.
你知道吗？耶稣能够帮助我们来爱我们的配偶。
He can help to love us to love our neighbors.
他能够通过爱我们，让我们得以来爱我们的邻舍。
Love others who may not be lovable.
你知道吗？爱这些邻舍，那邻舍有时候不是很可爱的。
So the encouragement today is to go to Jesus.
我今天要鼓励大家，让我们来到耶稣的跟前。
He loves you.
因为他爱我们。
And let's respond to his love by loving him back and loving our neighbors.
我们来回应耶稣对我们的爱，来爱耶稣，也来爱我们的邻舍。
Let's pray.
我们一起来祷告。
Heavenly Father,
亲爱的天父。
We thank you for your word.
我们为着你的话语献上感谢。
Your word is so truthful and it's so important to come, for it to come into our lives.
你的话语是如此的真实，如此的重要，让我们在我们的生命当中来实践你的话。
Lord, may you help each one of us to learn to love you and to love others.
主啊，求你帮助在场的弟兄姐妹能够来爱你，以及来爱我们周遭的人。
And will you help us to go throughout this week and allow us to experience that love from you so we can just pass it on to others.
主啊，在我们这个礼拜经过的时候，让我们能够领受你对我们的爱，让我们 用你对我们的爱来爱我们周遭的人。
May you just bless each one.
祝福在场的每位弟兄姐妹。
We pray in the name of Jesus.
祷告奉主耶稣基督的圣名。
Amen. May the Lord bless you. May the Lord keep you. May the Lord watch over you as you walk with him this week. Keep your eyes on Jesus. God bless you. Hope to see you here next week. God bless you.